It's a new month.
It's gonna be May.
Little engine go, bin 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 go. I'm losing control. Heroin and blow, Marilyn Monroe. Overdid dose, time to rip with pro. Up the inning dough, like a wind window. Little engine go, little engine go.
Good luck, everybody else.
You know, I thought about doing an album review on this, but in the end I was like, fuck it. My season 2 of Crap Rap is all about YouTube rappers. KSI is a YouTube rapper, and I'm making this in the one big episode of Crap Rap, so you're welcome.
Monster, you get in my way, I'ma feed you to the
monster.
I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a
monster.
When the moon shines like ice road truckers, I look like a villain out of those blockbusters.
I was gonna also cover his brother, Deji 2, but looking into him, it's mainly just like short diss tracks. He doesn't necessarily have a rap album out, but he does have a bunch of like dance, electronic, reggae, Christian gospel EPs out. Deji's was very weird, so I decided to just kind of leave him off since it was only like 3 diss tracks that I could find that were actually like rap and not whatever he was doing beforehand. But KSI has a lot of projects out, and he recently just released his debut album, Dissimulation, this past Friday. He also has 5 EPs, which are Keep Up, Jump Around, Space, Distraction, and, oh yeah, okay, no, it was 4 EPs, sorry, I put Keep Up on her twice. And then he's got a mixtape called New Age, which he did with a partner in this sense. So basically what I did is I listened to everything, but I basically want to give you my thoughts on his album overall, and then go into the other stuff. So here's the things I dislike. On his album Dissimulation, I mean, I don't know. He always has that weird kind of flow, and I guess every rapper has that flow, but to me, he kind of sounds like he's, like, trying to rip off Stormy's in a way, and Stormy's is actually a talented British rapper who, you know, does a good job bending and twisting these, you know, rap genres together. KSI, I believe, just tries too hard to do that, and his rapping style can come out very boring at times, and sometimes he just, like, shouts for no reason. Like, I know that could be a thing in rap songs, I understand, but it's just like, okay, whatever in this case. And his album features are just terrible. Like, who wants these features on their albums anymore? I mean, Poppin features Smoke, Perp, and Lil Pump, but what is it with the YouTubers just gravitating to Lil Pump? You know, the Dilbury brothers just put him in their weird music video thing, and now all of a sudden he's on a KSI album. Like, you know, Lil Pump's even relevant anymore. His album last year tanked, and now nobody really wants to hear from him. I've only heard maybe a couple of features from him since that album came out. No original material, and it just leaves you wondering, you know, what's next for Lil Pump? But that's not part of this video. He also had Swarms and Tion Wayne on Houdini, which is just a bad song in itself. On Bad Lil Vibe, he had Jeremiah on it, which, okay, Jeremiah, whatever. Then we have Wake Up Call, which was actually one I thought was, features Trippie Redd. And I will say Trippie Redd probably had the best feature on this thing. And I'm not a Trippie Redd fan to begin with, but he did fine. Killa 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 features Ayana Lee, and Down Like That features Lil Baby, who I can be up and down on, SX, who I don't know enough about, and Rick Ross. Okay. On one of his EPs, which is Distractions, which is basically just a EP full of, I believe, 5 or 6 diss tracks, Earthquake features Rice Gum, which we've covered on this channel. You know how I feel about Rice Gum as a person and as a rapper. Don't have a lot of good things to say. And then Adam's Apple is that big one, hold on, sneeze. Adam's Apple was that one controversial diss track he did on that one YouTuber, basically bringing his baby mama into the picture and telling him, hey, you know, you cut yourself, this and that, and, you know, you don't have, or basically denies him having any sort of depression whatsoever, and it's just like, dude, like, I get it's a diss track, but that's way too much of a low blow in this case, in this sense, and it's not even that clever to begin with. He thought he was clever flying out the dude's baby mama, and it's just like, it's been done before. We've saw the Pusha T and Drake thing where Pusha T brought Drake's kid into this, and I guess you were just, I mean, that probably happened before that, but, you know, it's just what goes on in the rap world. But some of the lyrical content and some of the insults were like, dude, that could have been, that could have been left out in private, just for the sake of whatever. Like I said, I know it's a diss track, and you gotta hit them where it hurts, but sometimes, there are still what you would call going too far in diss tracks. In this case, it is one of them. So, yeah, I guess that's basically it for the things I dislike about him. He just walks around like he's the most talented rapper on Earth, even though he says he isn't. He still just comes off as, like, I'm the best at what I do. The features he get are just so weak, and it's always diss track or, oh my god, they hate me, and yet I'm out here proving them wrong. It's basically the same thing over and over and over again. But looking through, there were some redeeming qualities. Oh my god, he's actually blowing his nose this time. Yeah, I got it ready. There are songs I found liking. Wake Up Call, as I mentioned, Down Like That were okay. Champagne, I do like the dark feeling on Creature. And Lambo Refueled was actually really pretty okay. I will say this. The production on most of his songs is actually, like, top, like, at the top of the list for, like, YouTube rappers. He probably has the best production of any of these YouTubers that do it, like a Jake or Logan Paul or a Rice Gum, you know. I feel like he actually, you know, spends the money to get the songs and get the projects as best as possible. And that's something I can really, really, you know, say good on him for. You know, and the fact that I know I'd said in the dislike he acts like he's the best rapper in the world. It's not necessarily, like I said, he came out of his mouth and said, I'm the best rapper in the world. He just kind of has that, like, act. But the fact that he's able to come out and say, you know, I'm not the best rapper in the world, that says a lot, because a lot of rappers who are crap will say they're the best thing in the world when they're living in this alternate reality. But at least Rice Gum will say it to you, be like, yeah, you know, I'm not the best rapper in the world. I enjoy doing it, but, you know, I don't think I have perfected, you know, that of the likes of some of the good rappers of today and of the past. I mean, you can definitely tell he's inspired by a lot of 90s hip-hop and a lot of today's hip-hop, and sometimes it mixes well, sometimes it doesn't. And I guess another thing is, too, that he didn't bot subscribers like his brother did. So at least there's that. At least his subscribers are genuine, and he has fans that are willing to basically just listen and watch anything he does. Again, I think he's one of those YouTubers that just has that, you know, fan base that no matter what, they will support him, they will stand by him. Even if he were to do something, like, really, really terrible, which I don't necessarily think he has. It's just been some of the diss tracks and some of the feuds he's gotten that have gotten him negative attention. And that drama he had with his brother, what, last year or a year and a half ago at this point, have gotten him some bad publicity, but nothing that you would say canceling him would be the case here. I wouldn't say he seems like a genuinely nice guy. He just seems like when he wants to be in the spotlight, he doesn't want it to be all drama and bullshit, and even he, minus the diss tracks, it seems like when something with his brother happens that he has no involvement in, or that whole feud between his brother, it seemed like he just wanted it to end. He wanted it over with, and he didn't want the negativity in the spotlight for this case. So that's just another thing I can appreciate him on, and his fans just being there and sticking with him, and, you know, just, you know, supporting him all the way through. That's always something you can see, even in all the bad, like, musicians and bad just YouTubers. Their following is very, very committed to what they do. I mean, look at Onision. This dude should have no support at all. If there's anybody we should be canceling, it's that dude. But yet he still has people to this day that defend him and back him up and say that his new content is still good. And, you know, when you have support like that, it can keep you going for longer than you think. and whatnot, although I don't think KSI will ever have to resort to making an OnlyFans, but that's just what it is sometimes. Before I go, I gotta rate KSI at a 3, I guess. He's not on the, you know, legs of, or the same ladder as the Paul Brothers and Rice Gum, who I took a look at in episodes 1 and 2 of this season, but he's got, like I said, redeeming qualities, and when he does put out a banger, he puts out a banger more often than not, but most of the time, it's a big swing and a miss, and I feel like if he were to just change his attitude and other than make it about, oh, I'm the underdog in this situation, or oh, I'm making a diss track on someone, I feel like it could be better, because he already works hard, but you know, he needs to change his appeal, I believe, at this point in time, because all of his EPs, his album, and his mixtape are different in ways, but they still just have that same feeling to him, where you're just like, can you sing about something else, or are you just stuck on being the underdog the whole time? Because I do believe that when he was in school, him and his brother were like the nerds. They weren't like the popular kids in school. Deji probably still would be categorized as a nerd, but KSI now, you know, he's with the big boys, he's with the people that I don't think he ever thought he'd be accepted by and whatnot, but he's still making it out, like, you know, hey, I'm not hot shit, you know, I was like most people in high school, or just most people in school in general, and now I'm just, you know, telling the haters, hey, for those of you that said I would go nowhere, was nothing, here I am now, and that I can appreciate, but at some point in time, you gotta go away from that, because I think once you ram it down their throat so many times, they understand that, oh, okay, this guy definitely proved us wrong, and that's when you start moving on to more serious topics in this sort of way. A lot of bands do it, even some rappers do it, it's just how it works most of the time in music. But yeah, that's it for episode 3 of season 2 of Crap Rap YouTuber Edition. You can tell me in the comments below, what do you think of KSI? Because to be honest with you, I think he's on his way to being one of the more better YouTube rappers. As a matter of fact, I think he is one of the better YouTube rappers out there. But it's just the repetitiveness in the lyrics and the topics and the fact that he relies heavily on diss tracks to get him somewhere is what's really, really holding him back, because he's got a good production, he's got a good supporting cast, but he just needs to make that little change that I think can really, really set him off. But yeah, that's it, guys. You can tell me in the comments below, what other YouTuber for this season do you want me to cover who does mainly rap stuff? They don't necessarily have to have an album or a project out. They just do a lot of, you know, music videos and whatnot on their channel, and it mainly involves rap in general. So stay safe out there, wash your damn hands, and until then, I will catch you all in the next one. Go. Go.